Hi, today is April 12th, 2015. I'm here with some amazing young crystal adults here, and it just happened. I showed up and there they were in front of Seaside Market. We're in a beautiful town called Cardiff by the Sea in California, and these young adults, we've always crossed paths in a general grocery store that we have here. And today the divine had just set up that both of these young ladies here had moments to talk to me, were willing to give their time in an interview in bridging the gap. They'd like to be part of the evolution motion, and because they'd like to leave a thumbprint behind as they get older to say they were part of this project. So how many of you feel like you're living your passion as creative entrepreneurs? Because I'm seeing this right now. How many of you feel like you're living your passion?
I am.
How's it feel?
Amazing.
Do you feel like there's still more for you to do, or you found it?
Oh, yeah.
Definitely.
I think that's in its nature. There'll never be really an end to it. By nature, it's growth.
So how do you know this about yourself?
Man.
Is it the way you feel, maybe?
I don't know. I feel like I know it because of the way I'm feeling about what I do and like how I live my everyday life.
I feel like my true self is limitless, is infinite. So anything that ties me down or limits me or puts a cap on how much money I make or what I can do, I'll be making quick steps to get away from that or release that from my life. So you can use those things like stepping stones, but getting attached to too many things sticks you to a certain frequency that you'll remain at. I think if you're not growing, you're dying. And then it's like, what are you doing?
Both of you agree with that?
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, I definitely agree. Like,
how do you feel, Flashlight? I love how she just chose this name to call Flashlight. So how do you feel about that for yourself? How much of that can you relate to?
Well, I just feel like we're all here for a reason. And we're all just trying to figure out what it is. And every day I just hope to become a better person than I was the day before, but obviously there's things in life that try to break you down, and I'll admit that sometimes I'm lazy. I probably don't live up to my potential, but definitely want to live up to as much as I can, I don't want to be older thinking back that I didn't make most of what I had.
So you feel like already at this point, at your ages, you know you're here for something greater?
Yeah, definitely.
Did anybody tell you that as a young age? Did any of your parents instill that, or you just intuitively knew inside?
Well, yeah, I think we were told the opposite.
Really? I was raised in a conservative background as far as like a Christian household. So basic underlying thing I was raised with was God has a purpose for you. Whether who is God or whatever it may be, I don't know, I was definitely raised with that idea that I was here for a reason. Plus, I was an accident, so I think that just kind of concurs with it. Like, completely unplanned, and I just made it, you know?
I can agree, I'm one of those. Yeah. And a baby with a big, giant mission. Nobody told me, nobody shared that with
That's
me.
Cool.
It's just all of a sudden, this was the mission. And it was like, okay, this, it won't leave me alone. And then you guys show up, and this is just like mind-blowing. So how about you, Harrison, you said, what did you say? Did you just came in knowing this?
Well, so growing up, you know, we're always told that you could do anything and anything's possible and follow your dreams, but then they kind of just turn into cliches that you see on the wall in your elementary school class, that the situation you're in completely contradicts what that's saying. So it kind of just becomes a cliche and nothing more. And people fall into the system of going to school, get good grades, get a job, work for 40 years
40
for years. 40% of your, you know, retire on 40% of your income. And that's pretty much it, and you make a certain amount.
So let me ask you, does that feel like you're living?
No, so when I was going through elementary school and school and everything, I always felt like I was, I guess, special, but not in, any sort of weird way, but I just thought I was different than everyone else. I thought I saw, like, the beauty in things, and I couldn't really talk about it because no one really understood. And
Let me just interrupt you there.
Yeah.
That is key. When with these crystal children, like you guys, I don't like to use the word children, but that's what it's been. Yeah. I like to call you crystal young adults. And the thing is, they inside feel different. They each know that they have a great mission, but they don't have the support as community. And that's what this is about, is to bring awareness, to bring all of you that have this great sense that you're here for a bigger purpose, and to create a community so that you don't feel alone. Like, you can have like meetings and, you know, live in like an apartment complex where then it becomes a community living than organic farming, and you guys will probably practice medicine differently. You'll be herbalism, and you'll have, you know, different ways, more natural techniques. So with Harrison expressing that he felt different, he innately knew, even though he felt he was wiser to get around the cliches. Flashlight, tell me a little bit more about how you felt, your purpose, your desire, your passion.
I just feel like I just constantly am looking around for signs, and they're all there. You just gotta look for them, you know? And it just, I think a problem with maybe our generation is that we just quit looking. Like, there's technology, there's ways to distract your mind, television. And then if you just take a step back and just, like, just take a little time in nature, then you'll just realize that there's a bigger picture for everything, you know?
I completely agree with you. One defining moment in my life is reading the book The Alchemist. And that completely changed my viewpoint about signs, and the fact that, like, the book even just states that, like, as a child, your eyes are almost open because you see everything around you in a different light, an innocent light. And then you grow older and these sets of reality hit you where you feel like you can't accomplish your dreams and your aspirations because bills, because this, because that, because... And then what happens when you get older, you just get flooded with all these everyday issues instead of realizing your purpose is greater than this. You have a defined kind of purpose. You have a faith, you have a reason, and to ignore that reason or that fate would be just kind of like, you know, like ending, like you said, like you're kind of like dying, you're not growing, you're not like doing what your fate would be.
Yeah, so. it's like the story we've just been telling ourselves up to this point until now tells us like who we are.
Yeah.
So if at this point everything up until then isn't the real you, it's just like what you've experienced, so then you immediately think that's you. Like, I guess if you want to be the best salesperson on the planet, but the only sales you've ever tried you failed at, so you tell yourself, oh, I'm the worst salesman ever. But if you can just tell yourself the story that, like, you're the best in the world and believe it, then
law of attraction.
Yeah.
Basically, law of attraction.
Whatever it's called.
What you think is what you receive. What you put out there is what you see. And positive thoughts, like you said, like exactly what you said.
Let me ask you, how do you feel about our politics today? Do you feel like it has anything to do with you?
No.
Let me answer that question with a question. Does it work?
Exactly. I love that. Does it work?
That is a very good question to be asking. And it, again, this is why I'm doing this documentary, is I can see this. I have this great vision that I can see this whole evolution that was coming from the 60s, but it got sidetracked and kind of stolen from those of us that were looking for free spirit. The one thing about our crystals, they're about harmony, and in order for them to bring harmony here, the indigos need to create the pathway, but they don't know that, and because there is an awareness, and that's the point of this documentary, is to bring awareness together. What time do you have to go to work?
In 20
minutes. Okay, so I have a question that I'm going to ask them in regards to if they feel like right now, if they can feel the stress of the old energy of what it is expected of them being here as young adults, like the old paradigm. So do you feel like it's going to influence you and shift you from your passion, or are you going to stay steadfast with your intuitive hits about what you guys want to do in this lifetime?
You go first.
I'll go first. All right. You know what? I think if you asked me this a year ago, I might have said yes. I definitely had this feeling of, like, you know, going for your college, like getting the job, like everyone has done, you know, that stability. After being 2 years in college and just like seeing a lot more of the world, and like after just like learning a lot more, and, like, about myself and about like what is going on around us and how everything's just kind of changing, I think personally, no, I don't think I would go the old route, because they've tried it and it worked before, but it's not, I don't think it's going to work now.
So you don't think the persuasion, I think that was the other point and the reason why I'm doing this, is that I think in your generation, a lot of the parents felt that if they can put you through a 4-year college and then maybe undergrad, that you would have stability. And what is happening now is there's so many higher educated adults, young adults, that can't find the jobs now because they were told they had security, and now they have student loans and they're taking jobs that'll pay you $10-$12 an hour. So a lot of them aren't getting that security. And what's happening is the craftsmanships are disappearing because the kids aren't taking the choices to do craftsmanships like welding, like mechanic work, or being a seamstress. It's just creating jewelry. I love it. Tell me what you do there with the creation of your jewelry.
Oh, well, I actually got these from somebody.
But you make your own?
Yeah, I do make my own jewelry. I make like usually just like mess around with hemp or just like get in the mood for it, I guess. I don't always make it, but sometimes I'll just be making it for like a straight week and just be addicted to it and then just drop it.
So tell me what got you into beading, because they used to bead a lot. They used to call them love beads in the 60s.
My older sister, she kind of was a big influence growing up, and she kind of came out from LA area and brought her, like, she was super cool and I looked up to her, and she was just like a big hippie. Just took a lot of advice, and she taught me a lot about growing up.
How much older than?
She's like 21 now, or no, she's not 21. She was like 21 when I was maybe like 11.
Okay.
So she's a little older now, has kids, so.
And she's an indigo. She probably doesn't know it, but she's an indigo. She's one of the ones that, she helped you pave the way a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then I love your glasses. And did you know that they used to wear those glasses in the 60s?
Yeah, actually, I've seen pictures of Jimi Hendrix specifically that like kind of inspired me with these like round. I love Jimmy. I love Jimmy to death. I love everything he stands for, the experience. You know, I even got a tattoo for him. It says Foxy Lady. I got these glasses super cheap, but I just like the style and.
Sorry.
I think you're very right when it comes to this generation. As far as all my friends, I didn't realize we love the 60s. We love the 70s. We love the music. We love the feeling. We love what it embodies. Everything about it, we love it.
And then, again, this is the point. My belief system tells me that the crystal children are reincarnated, not all of them, but most of them are reincarnated from the Vietnam War. They lost their lives short. And they came here in the 60s to create We All Want an Evolution, the songs from the Beatles, and it didn't happen. Your lives were cut short, fighting a war that was totally against your soul's belief system. And here you are again, reincarnating, that they're not going to draft you this lifetime. It's completely safe. And this time you get to live out your life fully as what you want to do, your passion, your harmony. So that's called, for me, it's called bridging the gap.